Hey, how come? All right. Hey, welcome to Arm Rats. My name is Randy Miller, and today I'm going to show you how to actually wrap a mini fridge. We're actually doing, this is actually a full service mini fridge wrap. So what it means is the customer doesn't want to do anything. And so what we're going to do is we bought the mini fridge, and then what they want to do is they want a full wrap, and then we ship it to the customer. Just that easy. So what I'm doing is, this actually a little demonstration is, this is on air release vinyl, matte sheen, and so if you don't want the full service, if you just want me to ship the vinyl to you, this is what you're going to get. So basically, if you want, what I like is the one unit piece, because you don't see the cut lines right here. Every customer is a little bit different. I'll email you if you want a full wrap mini fridge. I'll email you and ask you if you want a one piece or a three piece unit. Next, when you order a one piece unit for the sides and top, what we normally do, we cut the backing of it, as you can see right here, right along the edge. And what I recommend is pulling it down just a little bit, so it'll attack on. Okay, let me actually turn this around. Okay, and on the paper side right here, it is perfectly lined up to fit where it needs to be. And if you mess up, don't worry about it, you can pull it right back up. Actually, what I'll show you, if you just line it up like right about there, you can probably just go like this. Next, hold this down, making sure it's lined up all the way where you're supposed to be. Perfect. Okay, next. With every order, you actually get a squeegee and a knife. So what I like to do is pull it right, not to the edge of the table, but pretty close to the edge of the table. And I just like to double check everything. So next, is I just roll it up, and I grab the bottom back paper. Start going down. If you have a little crease in it, no big deal. Just pull it up. And what I'm doing is I'm pulling it down just a little bit. I'm not pushing a lot of things on it. Now I just pull it down, the backing. I'm pulling this down that way, so it's even pressure. Plug it down just a little bit. Okay. Thank you. there's no air bubbles are in it. If there is, you just massage it out. We do a lot of custom prints. Okay. Next. We're gonna go this way next. Loop it over. And normally take your time. I'm on the, usually I do this on the floor, but I'm trying to show people on the camera. And you just kind of pull the paper this way. And like I said, if you mess up a little bit, don't worry about it. It's narrowly spinal, you can pull it right off. Just like that. And just kind of walk it, backing the paper. Okay. And what I did before, for time wise, I took did the hinge off, it was on top. So I take the hinge off, I cleaned everything up with the rubbing alcohol, and I made sure there's no symbols or anything in the way. But now, I grab my thumb, and I pull my hand down this right here, and I stretch it a little bit. So I'm just basically tacking it on. Now I'm pulling the back of the paper, and I'm not putting a lot of pressure on, just enough just to hold it on. And if you've never done it before, it's a little nerve-wracking, but once you understand the vinyl, and I'm trying to show everyone, it's really not that hard to install. Okay. You can see how I'm lifting this up. No big deal. I got a little air bubble in it. I'm massaging it out. Right about there. And if you get anything underneath it, you can pull it up. Get it down. Alright, so the next thing I'm going to do, I got my knife. Like I said, I took the door off. Well, I should have done a super door off before I installed it. Okay, now, on the edges right here, go right at the edge of this, and I go outwards. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to push it in. I pull my hand out this way, and I bring my thumb out. Okay, there's a little crease right here. You can't see it, but there's a little crease. I'm just going to follow that crease, and I'm going to cut the excess off. And then I'm going to put my fingernail in there to follow the line of the metal. Nice clean edge. Okay, same thing. Pull my hand this way. And I'm stretching the vinyl, making sure there's no air bubbles in there or anything like that. I'm not pushing really hard, I'm just actually tacking it on. You can see a lot more designs on the armwraps.com website. And I'm going to be coming out with new... If you have long fingernails, I don't have long fingernails. If you have long fingernails, you can just cut with your fingernails. Okay, last but least, do the top. Again, try to find that little crease mark right there. A lot of times it's better just using your fingernails to go in. Okay, you find the crease mark right there, and then you kind of cut. You can use your fingernails, or you can actually use your squeegee to get into the grooves. If you got any comments or questions, comment down below and I'll respond to you after I get done with the video. Okay, let's do the backing now. So if you want a full service, you're more welcome to check it out. What that includes is we go out, the arm wraps, we go to Walmart or Best Buy or Home Depot or Lowe's. We pick the fridge out that you want or what they have in stock right then and there if you're not too picky about the mini fridges. And we make a custom buy button on our website. You can see how much it would cost, what the vinyl's gonna look, or what the product's gonna look like before we even touch anything. It's all photoshopped on there. And if you have a man cave or a business, you want to promote the business, you can put your stuff on there, logos, you name it. But basically, we're here for your services. And also uniqueness and the coolness of a mini fridge wrap or skin. And we give good, great detail on the quality of the stuff, from the prints to actually on the back of the mini fridge, because we want to make it look as best as good we can. It's the detail stuff that we care about. As you can see right here, we do table wraps too. We do all kinds of kind of fun, unique wraps. Diamond. So you can see that's one side, that's the other side, that's the top. I'm not going to show you the bottom because it's rated PG today. Okay, the next step we're going to do, we're going to put the door wrap on next. Okay, hold on, I'm going to do something real quick. Okay, with the door wrap, I had to take the door off. It's a lot easier installing the sides and top with the door off. Okay. I'm gonna put this on here real quick. If you like this video, subscribe to me or you can see a lot more. But also like it, it just makes it feel better when people like it and show that there's a market out there, and makes me want to do more videos. And that's what I'm possibly doing, is a lot more videos to show people. And I'm being as transparent as possible about this business. And is there any comments or questions, comment down below. We're going to do one little thing. Things are flying today. So the customer ordered this last week, and I made a custom buy button on the website. And I asked him, what do you want? And he said he wanted the mini fridge around the 4.3 cubic feet. And so what we did was I went down to Walmart, I got it. We're having bad luck with Amazon. And every time someone orders from Amazon, it comes dented. We got like 80% of the time it's dented. That's the reason why we're starting to buy local. So we buy it, we unwrap it, make sure there's no dented. It's a heck of a lot quicker and a lot easier for us and you guys to come late. Okay, so what I did is I pulled the backing off just enough, a little bit. And I could just tack it where I think it's going to be. And you can pull it off, move it on, move around. And every order is custom sized. So if you order, if it's an 18.5 by 32, I always add 2 inches around the side, so it goes all the way around. So right now, I'm just doing, I'm just tacking the sides. And then I'm making sure it goes all the way down. It does, and I'm gonna make sure it goes all the way around to the sill. Hey, looks good. So right now, it's tacked on the sides, or right on top. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull the paper down a little bit. I use my thumb, and then I'm just gonna walk it down enough. Next, I'm going to start using my squeegee, and there's little air bubbles in it, no big deal. So what I'm doing is I'm holding the paper down, or the vinyl, and I'm just kind of slowly walking it down.
Any time between 9:30 and 5 over here, you need a speed.
So if you see any air bubbles in it, no big deal. That's just massage it out. We're coming up with a lot of unique designs, something fun, different, man caves, businesses.
Father's Day.
What else is there? Holidays. Birthdays, whatever. And if you have your own image that you want to use, you're more than welcome to use your own image. I'll look out over it, making sure it's a printable image. If it isn't, I'll tell you. So if you got a little air bubble in it, that's what happens right here. I'm kind of slowly, slowly doing it. And if you get any struggles, or something happens, or if you need to get a hold of me or the shop, you're more than welcome to call me. I surprise a lot of people when they answer the phone call. So when you get in the bottom, every once in a while you get little creases or anything like that, you just pull it up and you push it right back down. And that's what I'm doing, as you can kind of see. If I get a little crease right here, I just pull that, put it back down. No big deal. Hey, I got a massive air bubble right here. So what I'm gonna do, I can pull it up, or I could just poke a little hole right here. Use my thumb and get rid of it. So right now I'm kind of feeling if there's any air bubbles or creases or anything like that. There's a crease right here. And a lot of times, if there's a crease right in the middle of it, we can actually take a heat gun to it and get rid of the crease. Got just a lot of little air bubbles. And that's why I'm just being a little nitpicky. Okay, so next, what I do, I shove the squeegee as far as I can up there. Okay, your squeegee is acting like a guard. So you put the squeegee up right here, and you actually use your knife to cut along. What the squeegee does, it gives it a little gauge. You go up. Give it a little thickness on there so it's not directly going right to the metal. It's hitting the black strip up. So I go right in the corner and I go upwards. I go at a 45 degree angle upwards. Okay, so let's see. How's the main camera doing?
Good. Okay.
Sometimes that thing overheats. So the same thing as the bottom, I go on a 45 degree angle down right at the corner. Down. So I'm using this as a guide again. You don't need to use your squeegee all the time. Same thing. Use your squeegee as a guard. You go 45 up. Okay, now the trick is, you open the door and you shove it all the way around. Use your thumb. You don't have a lot of vinyl left, so. Okay, at the very end, you use your squeegee. And it's buttered up right up to it. The reason why I like using the vinyl instead of the magnets, because the magnets you can't get as tight and as good as a look you want as a vinyl wrap. Every once in a while people ask me, can you do magnets, and I tell them no. I want a good quality vinyl look. I want a solid look. I don't want anything that represents a bad quality job. Okay, again. I'm using my finger. If you get a little crease, no big deal. Like I just got, you pull it up. And I'm just walking it in. I guess. There you go. Cutting along the line of the stripper. That's basically it. Alright, if you got any comments or questions, comment down below. And if you need anything, give me a call. My name is Randy Miller. Phone number is 208-696-1180. Check out my website, rmwraps.com, or if you want to email me at rmwraps@gmail.com. Thanks, guys, and stay tuned. I got more videos coming.